Namaste. It's Fran, again. And I want to put out a very special thanks to everyone who helped with the Kickstarter campaign for the Peach Fuzz. It was such an overwhelming success. Launched it in January as a 14-day campaign, and it sold out completely in just 12 days. And I have, I'll put a link in the description for the page, but you can go there and see the progress as the whole thing came together, but fulfilled the entire campaign and shipped out everything last week. And so the whole thing came to a close from the finishing of the campaign to the shipping of the last petals in just 8 weeks, which is a full month ahead of my intended schedule. So it was just a success all around. And it did so well that I plan to launch another Kickstarter for the return of the Cream Puff in April. And I will certainly put links and a video when I do. It's just I was kind of not skeptical, but I was cautious about crowdsourcing. 'Cause crowdfunding, it has a dubious reputation, and there are a lot of risks. I mean, when you do a crowdfunding campaign, like I did on Kickstarter, there are certain obligations, and there are definitely expectations, as there should be, for the campaign to go well, and also for the fulfillment of what you promise, and to keep it on a schedule. And I'll tell you, it is difficult when you're manufacturing something, especially manufacturing something as complicated as an effects pedal that has many different levels of manufacturing involved in it. There are so many details that have to come together on a very, very tight schedule and on a tight budget for it all to happen and be realized. I really got a sense, working under the schedule, of where a lot of these crowd-funded projects fail. I definitely had a lot of snags, but what I had going for me was the benefit of my experience in manufacturing for over 2 decades. So I had expectations that there would be snags, and I also had tools and skills to get around snags when they happened. And so very different, I think, for a person who is got a lot of experience in the industry that they're making the product in, as opposed to someone who would have a startup that they really wouldn't have any clue about those little details about how to get around those fine little hang-ups that happen. You might think, what could those hang-ups be? Well, a lot of it is just tiny little things, parts that you would expect to have or that you can get, in a handful that you have to order in large volumes. You will find that, these parts maybe aren't available, or maybe it's a part that is only manufactured by a manufacturer, to order. Maybe it's not something that's stocked in distributors and such, and then you place an order for a large quantity of them, and you got to wait, months and months for them to make them. Things like that really can smash a crowdfunding project. But suffice to say that, Frantone got around all the hurdles, and we ended up making great Peach Fuzzes. They sound great. I played every single one of them. I built every single one of them. So they sound good and they look great. New kind of finish as opposed to the old epoxy that I used to use. Now using a baked polyester enamel, which is super, super tough. When you bake that enamel after it's cured, a polymerization process happens where all of the molecules of paint, they all molecularly bond and cross-link to one another, and essentially what happens is the entire coating on the piece ends up being one single molecule, a continuous molecule, like a quartz crystal. So it's very, very, very strong. It's very strong. So I'm very happy with it, the finish. So the Kickstarter campaign for the Peach Fuzz was intended not only to allow me to fulfill the backers, but also to have enough components to make another run of pedals, which I'm doing currently. So those of you who wanted to get in the Kickstarter campaign but didn't get in time and still want a Peach Fuzz, I'm making the second lot right now, and those will be ready in April as well. And you can get on the list to pre-order one if you go to the website, which I'll put a link in the description. There's a link on the homepage for just email me. Just say, hey, you know, put me on the list for a Peach Fuzz. And when they're ready, I will, you know, I'll notify people in the order that the pedals are made. And you can get a chance to buy one of the second run of Peach Fuzzes in April. So keep visiting the Frantone website for updates. I will post updates there whenever I have them and change the homepage. And just as a little side note, those of you who follow my Twitter feed, and if you don't, please do. It's where I really put my updates of what I'm doing day to day, and particularly if you're interested in my projects and stuff, I put updates on the Twitter feed as they happen. Well, on my Twitter feed, I put a link a couple times to this petition on change.org to try to get Fuji to continue making their pack film for Polaroid cameras. The FP100C, which is the professional grade color pack film for land cameras, they have ceased production, which is very sad because there are still so many people who still shoot Polaroids, including myself. And so a person put this petition up, and I'll put a link in the description. But if you really want to help out in trying to get Polaroid film to stay in production for these great cameras, which so many people still use, including myself, and you can use them too, they are readily available, and you can refurbish them, and there's lots of tips online about how to refurb them and get them up to use modern batteries. I even have a little posting on my science blog about how to convert one of these older Polaroid cameras for a modern hot shoe for a flash, which I did on my camera. But if you sign the petition, help keep something that's really valuable and needed and wanted alive, and that's Polaroid pack film. I really, really would hate to see it disappear entirely. I mean, we all went through this, photographers. Those of you who are photographers shooting film, we all went through this when Kodak stopped making Kodachrome. Kodachrome was, you know, for 35 millimeter film, was the it was the standard, Kodachrome. And when Kodak stopped making Kodachrome and stopped processing Kodachrome film, it was a sad and dark time. It was really the end of a really great era. And the idea that Polaroid pack film is still around, it's just one of the last good things still in existence, and it would just be sad to see it go altogether. So please, if you have a moment, go to the link, go to the change.org page, sign the petition, help keep something great in the world. And we certainly need great things in the world, like film. So anyway, that's it for this, and I'll be back with an update on other things that are going on in April. Like I said, finishing up Peach Fuzzes, we're going to do Cream Puffs next, so keep an eye out for that. I help with the Polaroid film. So, that's it. I'm Fran. Bye.